नमस्कार, आई एम डॉक्टर मनीषा आचार्य, सीईओ ऑफ इंडिग्राम लव्स फाउंडेशन। फर्स्टली आई वुड लाइक टू गिव माय हार्टफेल्ट थैंक्स टू नॉर्थ ईस्ट साइंस मूवमेंट फॉर गिविंग मी ए चांस टू शेयर माय आइडियाज ऑन द रोल ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी बिजनेस इंक्यूबेटर टू डेवलप द टेक स्टार्टअप इकोसिस्टम इन द कंट्री। बिफोर गोइंग टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ माई टॉपिक, आई वुड लाइक टू गिव ए ब्रीफ डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट माई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। Indigram Labs Foundation is a technology business incubator having thrust areas of agri-tech, food-tech, clean-tech, and rural healthcare. It is supported by National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board, DST, Government of India. It is also supported by BIRAC, which is under the Department of Biotechnology, and the Ministry of MSME through Aspire Scheme. Within a short span of 4 years, Indigram Labs Foundation has supported nearly 100 startups through our both incubation and acceleration activities. We are providing 360-degree support to the startups like seed fund support, market linkage, field testing and trials of their products, networking, IPR support, and also the co-working space. Our incubated startup, it covers almost all the tech areas up in agriculture and food technology, like precision agriculture, IoT-enabled vertical indoor and semi-indoor farms, farm digitization, intelligent fishing solution, off-grid installation of micro cold storage, e-commerce models for the tractors and livestock farming, farm-to-fork models for the FMB products, solutions across the assaying, grading, of agri-commodities, food traceability, soil testing, etc. These are all technology-based startups, tech-enabled startups. We also have the collaboration with several international incubator and accelerators across the globe, which helps our startups for the soft landing in different places of the world, particularly in USA and Europe. Further, with our incubation activities, we also conduct different theme-based acceleration program. Like in 2018, we did a acceleration program for the startups in Northeast India in food and agri sector. In that acceleration program, we have supported 10 startups. And also we have a plan to conduct the acceleration program again in Northeast India during 2021. And if possible, we also have a plan to set up an incubator itself in Northeast India. Our host organization, ISAP, which is the Indian Society of Agribusiness Professional, has done a remarkable work over the last 20 years in the field of agriculture and has network of around 5 lakh farmers and 235 FPOs. ISAP has also created more than 2,000 agri micro entrepreneurs through the SABC program of MANES. This initiative prompted ISAP to set up a technology business incubator with the support from DST, Government of India. If you see that there are very few non-academy incubators which are supported by Government of India, and Indigram Labs Foundation is one of them. Our incubators have directly or indirectly touched more than 5 lakh farmers and have created more than 1,500 jobs. Our host organization have FPOs, so they can do their pilot testing through these FPOs for their products and services, and that is very much required for the agri startup to do the pilot test on the field itself. That is then the farm, they can connect with the farmers, and we are providing them. That is our USP. Now I would like to tell you what exactly the business incubator is all about and how they are helping the technology-based startups through a small presentation. So what exactly the Business Incubation Center? Now, as the The entrepreneurial ecosystem is flourished throughout in the world. Everybody knows that it is very much required to develop the startup ecosystem. If that startup ecosystem will develop, then the economic condition of that particular country will also develop. So in addition to, there are different players in the entrepreneurial ecosystem with the startups, and business incubator is the most important part of this ecosystem. Through the business incubation system, it is an institutional support system that is that to manage the innovation. So if you see that in the right side of the picture, that is one baby in an incubator. Why we will keep the premature baby in incubator? That will help them. We keep the premature baby in an incubator for few hours or for few days also, so that their immune system will develop and they face the outside world properly. In the same manner, from that particular incubation thing, that business incubator term will also come. That is, in the same way, if a business incubation system will also help the startups to grow and to be success, and they can face the world, face outside the world when their business will grow. Business incubation center also the bridging the gap between the R&D output and the commercialization. And that is the reason why we'll see the most of the business incubation incubators in the academic institute, because that will help the academic institute, the faculties, the researchers, the students to make their innovation to commercialization, so that society will also get the benefits of their innovation. So if you see the incubator, each and every letter depicts a particular or anything related to startup. Just like I is for the innovation and entrepreneurship, N is the network and collaboration, C is competitiveness, U is the understanding the roles, B is to buy in, A into access to resources, T technologies, O to outreach, and R to review, monitoring, and evaluation. So why incubation centers are needed for the innovators? What is the requirement? Why there are so many incubation centers in different parts and all over the world? And why the numbers are increasing day by day in India also? Because in an incubation center, a startup will get a proper work environment where they can work with their innovation properly to make it commercialize. They also get the proper mentoring support, proper the business, the subject matter experts, to get that mentoring support in the management skill that is very much required for a techno entrepreneurs, because techno entrepreneurs are normally very good in their technology side, their innovation side, but they are lacking on the management side. So that things the incubation centers, the duty of the incubation center to teach them that skill. And also they get the office space in a very nominal rate, because from on the they will take the outside the office space, that will the very that rate is very high. So it is that will not possible to have effort for the startup. So that they can get a very office space in a very nominal rate in incubator. They get a proper different professional networking and collaboration through an incubator. Another thing is very important thing, that is the investment chances. Through an incubator, startup can get the prototype grant, seed funding support. Because for a startup, it is not possible that a bank will give a fund for a very early startup, or an investor can invest for a very early startup. It is the incubator who will invest with the startup through their seed fund support, through their different grants. Another thing is the lab support, laboratory support. Particularly for tech startup in biotechnology and some in different engineering startup also, it is not possible for them to purchase different costly equipments and to do their R&D. So they in the incubator, they can get this R&D support through their lab. Another thing is the different services in the nominal charges like legal, IPR, IT, all these things related to all these things, they get from the incubators. So what are the types and models of incubators? There are different, if you see the, in the types, it may be in the academic institute, it may be in corporates, it may be in non-profit organization. In academic institute, if you see in India, that mostly in almost all IITs, IIM, engineering college, different university, they have their incubation center. Because As I previously also told that in academic institute is very much required to establish an innovation incubator, because that will help the researcher, the faculty members, the students to make their innovation to enterprises. So that innovation will exact use of that innovation, the society will get the exact use of that innovation. So mostly in the, if you see in USA, in Stanford University or Harvard or MIT, lots of academic innovation, that innovation come from the lab, will come to successfully commercialize. And that is also in India also possible. And now also we are doing many innovators now coming from this academic institute, and they can successfully commercialize their innovation. So in corporates, also there are many corporates, they have now established their own incubator and accelerator. Like in Microsoft, there is a very good acceleration program in Microsoft. In nonprofit organization, there are a few nonprofit organizations who have established their incubation center. Like in our case, Indigram Labs Foundation, our host organization is Indian Society of Agribusiness Professional, which is a nonprofit organization. If you see the infrastructure aspect, what are the types of incubator? It can be physical incubator or virtual incubator. Physical incubator mostly will get in academic institute, and virtual incubator mostly in corporate sector. If you see the legal status, most of the incubators are non-profit, but very few are also for profit. Focus thing, some incubators are very sector specific. Like in our case, Indigram Labs, it is a very sector specific. We focused on agri, food, and clean tech. But in some incubation center, they are sector agnostic, and they can support to any type of innovation. So what are the goals of a technology business incubator? The single goal of a technology business incubator is to successfully commercialize an innovation. That is the single goal. And how to do that things? They can help the funding by giving the funding support to startup, by giving the mentoring support to startup, by providing the networking and collaboration support to startup, by different other value addition to the startup in there. And sometimes there are different type of certification is required. How they will get, on what process they will get, that will also the incubation center's duty to help them. And also the IP protection, they should help the their startup. So if you see, an incubator cannot run in silos. They need different ecosystem player to run successfully. And to when an incubator, they have a different collaborator or partnership with different organization, different industry, different investors, government, university R&D center, different service provider, corporates, then actually they can help a startup properly. Startups with from this collaboration and this ecosystem player, startup will get the different benefits, and that to scale up, they can achieve the things that to scale up, they can easily achieve to commercialize to scale up. So, it is not possible for a startup to connect himself to individual different ecosystem players. It can be possible through an incubator very easily to connect with different ecosystem player for a tech startup. So what are the incubation process and services? What are the different steps of incubation? Suppose one startup will come, and what are the process he has to come, he has to do for this incubation support? So first is the pre-incubation. That is, in pre-incubation stage, an incubator will evaluate their idea. They will see if this idea can commercialize or not, that commercialized aspects is present or not, or how is the entrepreneurial attitude of that innovator. That one incubation center will evaluate. After that evaluation and everything, they will sign an agreement with the startup. That is the incubation stage, that proper incubation stage. In that stage, one startup will get the they will get the prototype grant, they will get the seed fund support, they will get the coaching, mentoring, and different type of trainings, training, collaboration, different type of partnership opportunities, different types of collaboration opportunities, networking opportunities, and all this, and the refinement of their business plan. And that last is the post-incubation. In post-incubation stage, if you see it, after they will get the from any investor, they will get any investment, institutional investment, then they will graduate. So there are now the different Ministry of Government of India are supporting the innovation and entrepreneurship through entrepreneurship, and they run different funding and funding program and different funding and different program for the startups through incubators, and it happens very successfully. I'll show you the how the different ministries are running their programs and what are the different programs what they run through the incubation center. There is funding schemes of National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board, Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. They have one scheme, that is the National Initiative for Developing and Harnessing Innovation, that is NIDHI. Under NIDHI scheme, they have established different NIDHI TBI. They have also the NIDHI seed fund support. This seed fund support, they provide to different incubators up to 10 crores. This 10 crores will to give the startups as a seed fund. This startup can use that seed fund support to in product development, in testing, trial, for the test marketing, mentoring, professional consultancy, manpower. So, and normally they get up to, they get 25 lakhs to 50 lakhs from an incubator, but in occasionally, if the rare case, that is in a special case, you can say that is one startup can get up to 1 crore also from an incubator. There is another scheme is NIDHI Prayas. It is also run in different Prayas center of DST. This is to up to maximum 10 lakhs grant to develop it a prototype. It is a prototype grant. Another scheme is NIDHI EIR, that is Entrepreneurship in Residence. It is for the first generation innovators who has no prior source of income. This is also run in different NIDHI EIR center. EIR center are present in different incubators. Innovators can get minimum 10,000 per month to 30,000 per month maximum, up to 12 months. There are different funding schemes under BIRAC of Department of Biotechnology for the biotech startups. For biotech startups, there are very number of good schemes present in under BIRAC, from ideation stage to late stage development. Suppose one biotech startup have a very good idea, they can get up to 50 lakhs grant under BIG. And after that, they can apply to SIBRI, BIPP to for the late stage development. So in under BIG grant, there are several biotech startups successfully developed their prototype. Under Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, they have also two schemes which run through in Business Incubation Center. One is the MSME BI, that is to support from the entrepreneurial and managerial development of SMEs through incubators. One startup can get the to develop their prototype. It is the grant up to 15 lakhs or the 75% to 85% of the project cost. There is another scheme, that is the MSME Aspire. That is particularly for the promotion of innovation in rural industry and entrepreneurship. This fund also routed through the Technology Business Incubator. One startup can get the 4 lakhs grant for idea to POC and 20 lakh as a seed capital fund. There is also the TIDE 2.0 scheme of MeitY. Under this scheme, the ICT startups can get the benefits primarily they are the different emerging technologies such as the IoT, AI, blockchain, robotics, and in any of the area, like in healthcare, education, agriculture, clean tech, clean energy, financial inclusions, or any other emerging areas who are using this technology of ICT, that startup can get the benefits under the TIE 2.0 EIR and TIE 2.0 grant. Under TIE 2.0 EIR, it is a grant fellowship for 4 lakhs per startup, and grant 2.0 grant, it is the 7 lakhs per startup. That is to develop the proof of concept. There are several Atal Incubation Center under the, which is established by Atal Innovation Mission across India. There are numbers are most probably 59 Atal Incubation Center in different parts of the India, and they run very successfully all these incubation centers. So if you see the numbers, how many numbers are incubators in India? There are almost more than 400 incubation centers which are supported by different ministries of government of India. Like in BIRAC, there are 15 BioNest, under DST around 170 incubation centers. Under Atal Innovation Mission, it is 59 to 60 incubation centers. Under MSME Aspire, that is 16 incubation centers. There are some livelihood incubators also under MSME. Under MSME BI, around 120 plus incubation center, and under RKBY, that is RKBY Raftar Center, that is under the Ministry of Agriculture, there are around 25 RKBY Raftar centers are present in India. So if you see that how these incubation centers are, what is the role of this incubation center? Why these incubation centers are very important? Now we understood that incubation centers are playing as the catalyst for the early stage tech startup to scale up and further growth. All these government funded programs and funding schemes for the startups are run very successfully through this incubation center. During this COVID-19 situation also, during this COVID-19 pandemic, incubators are playing a very powerful role. They have joined their hands with the government and to make all innovators successful. It is very much required to make all incubation centers to be properly organized and to help the startups. Hope you all will like my talk. Thank you.